Hello and welcome back to another Cloudwards.net video. My name is Mauricio and today we are going to be comparing two of the best cloud storage options out there right now, Dropbox and sync.com. Dropbox is one of the earliest cloud storage companies and really brought about the kind of convenient, easy to use form of cloud storage that we know today. Sync.com, on the other hand, was founded years later, but offers its own set of distinct advantages, specifically when it comes to security, that really make it stand out, and we'll get into that in just a moment. But first, I'd like to remind you to subscribe if you like our videos and hit that bell icon. That way you'll get a notification with our latest uploads and reviews. Let's look at pricing first. Dropbox offers 2 gigabytes of storage for free and offers 2 sizes of storage, either 2 terabytes or 3. Each of these can be purchased in either monthly increments or annual, with the 2 terabyte plan costing around $12 a month and the annual option bringing that down to about $10 per month. The 3 terabyte plan called Dropbox Professional will cost you a pretty substantial $20 a month. It adds more advanced features like 180-day file recovery, text search in documents, and sending files up to 100 gigs. Despite only offering annual signup options, sync.com is very hard to beat when it comes to pricing. For starters, it offers 5 gigs for free compared to Dropbox 2. There are also a wider variety of plans available, ranging from a meager 200 gigs that costs $5 a month, all the way up to a 4 terabyte plan that costs $15, cheaper than Dropbox's 3 terabyte plan. For direct comparison, sync.com's 2 terabyte plan comes out to only $8 a month, and the 3 terabyte plan is only $10. So sync.com wins in pricing, hands down. But Sync also has an advantage when you compare the same range of plans. The 3 terabyte Pro Solo plan has a 365 file version history built in, and there is no share transfer limits like you find on the professional Dropbox plan. Speaking of file sharing, Dropbox certainly holds its own in this regard and lets you share using a link on the website as well as directly from your desktop. Dropbox also lets you set expiration dates for links and shared files, but only if you have the pricey professional plan. Sync.com also lets you set up expiry dates on shared files, but gives you even more control over your files with things like download limits, and you can even give you notifications when there's activity on a shared file. You can also set passwords for files and see download stats to know how many times a file has been downloaded. So again, sync.com wins this round without a doubt. Where Dropbox begins to show its strength is in its speed. Dropbox has multiple data centers in both the US and Europe, which gives it a very impressive speed on initial uploads. On top of this, Dropbox has features like block-level syncing and smart sync to speed things up even more. Sync.com, on the other hand, uses only 1 data center located in Canada. This results in slightly slower speeds, but on top of that, sync.com works with much, much greater security, which we'll get into shortly. Sync's zero-knowledge encryption causes things to be a bit slower and rules out the possibility of sync.com ever being able to support features like block-level syncing. So Dropbox edges out on this round. Now, as I just mentioned, part of the difference in speed between Dropbox and sync.com is due to the fact that Sync offers tighter security. Dropbox does not support zero-knowledge encryption and uses a lighter encryption, AES-128, for file transfers. Your files are then decrypted and re-encrypted once on the server in order for Dropbox to scan the metadata of those files. While this means much greater speed and obviously easier access to your files, the downside is that security isn't that great. Sync.com, by contrast, encrypts your files with a stronger AES-256 encryption before it even leaves your computer. These files are then never decrypted on Sync's service and only get decrypted once the files are back on your computer. This setup sacrifices speed in favor of security. Zero-knowledge encryption means only you have the decryption key for your data. Sync.com is the clear winner when it comes to security here. Finally, we want to mention the privacy that each of these companies offers its users. Dropbox privacy policy outright states that it will look at your files to ensure that you aren't violating its terms of service. Dropbox is also integrated with numerous third parties, which is convenient and can certainly help with certain productivity tasks, but also means that your data is ending up in more hands. Sync.com's privacy policy is a stark contrast to this and outlines Sync's 10 privacy principles, one of which is to always ask your consent before collecting or disclosing your personal information. On top of this, Dropbox is based in the US while Sync is in Canada. While not too distant, the laws on the Canadian side are much more favorable to those interested in maintaining their privacy. So again, Sync.com is the clear winner in my book. While it's pretty clear that Sync.com is the better cloud storage option, there is a lot more to this story that I haven't entirely covered in this short video. If you're interested in getting more information about each of these providers, I'll leave links to our full articles on these providers in the description box below. Also, do make sure to check out our video review on Sync.com in the card above here. You can also try out both of these cloud storage services for free, so I'll leave links for that as well down in the description box. It doesn't hurt to sign up for both and play around for a while to see which one suits your needs best. As always, thank you very much for watching, and please remember to like this video if it helped you out and subscribe to see more of our upcoming reviews. See you soon.